welcome to the afternoon markets update from Nirmal Banga. I'm Iral Dadia. Clearly, it has been a volatile day of trade as expected in the morning session, because clearly you did see the equity indices that opened a gap down to start the session, but soon it paired the losses partially. Right now as well, if you go to see, it was mainly the pandemic jitters that have actually taken a toll on the domestic equity indices, and because they've been actually following their global peers, and this is after the US officials have come out and warned of the spread of the coronavirus in the country. In fact, you have the CDC that actually alerted Americans as well yesterday to begin preparing for the spread of coronavirus in the United States after the infections have surfaced in several more countries. So this is one of the major reasons why we're seeing these kind of jitters that is coming in. Again, as we've mentioned earlier as well, that F&O expiry is something which is causing this kind of volatility. So you need to cap your stop losses as well. Clearly, beyond that, if you see right now in terms of where markets are concerned, we are trading off the day's lows. We have, however, extended the decline for a fourth consecutive session, and Nifty has again come back above that 11,750 mark. Bank Nifty as well, it's trading at levels of around 30,400, though we are seeing marginal cuts of around 0.2%. Broader markets is pretty interesting. It's a pretty mixed trade coming in on that front. You have the mid-cap index, which is down almost 0.5%. However, there are some green shoots that are emerging on the small-cap index as well, which is up almost around 0.1%. Majority of the sectoral indices have been on the losing end. However, there is a mild recovery that has come in on the telecom space, which is up around 0.5% in trade. Realty, metals, energy and auto, these are the ones which are taking a slide in trade today. The market breadth also is pretty much in favor of the bears, and there is that pressure coming in from the feeble global cues that we have been picking up. In fact, on the global front, you have India and US who have finalized the defense deals as well, worth almost around $3 billion, but no major sentimental up move this news is actually providing. Clearly, as indicated, the volatility is expected to remain high ahead of the Feb series monthly expiry, which will be tomorrow. And the traders, as we know, will be rolling over their F&O positions in the March series as well. In fact, either directional moves that we will see, the volatility will remain high. And 11,700 put, if you go to see, the option premium has jumped by almost around 49% on that front. So watch out for this pretty closely. On the Sensex as well, almost around 19 stocks have been trading in the red. And after falling nearly 400 points at opening, it was Sensex that recouped early losses. And the mid-cap index, as we mentioned, is down around 65 to 70 points. Very quickly, few factors, let's highlight them, which are impacting and weighing them on the markets. You have the weak Asian markets, that's one. US coronavirus warning, that's number two. And the F&O expiry on Thursday is number three. So these three are the ones which are actually weighing on the markets right now. Let's quickly take at the movers, you know, the top gainers. On Nifty 50, you have Yes Bank, Britannia, Power Grid. These are a few of the names. On the losing end, you have Sun Pharma, Tata Motors, Hindalco, as well as Wipro. If you talk about broader markets, India Cements, a strong move coming in on India Cements. In fact, if you see India Cements, that stock has surged almost 40% in the last two trading sessions. And overall, if you go to see, beyond that, you have Star Cement, Prism Johnson, ITD Cementation, which are supporting. Counters that are losing, you have Lemon Tree Hotels, Adani Transmission. Gayatri Projects as well has continued the downward spiral for the last couple of trading sessions. And a future consumer has joined the pack. Talking about stocks which are at a 52-week high, Abbott India, Sanofi India, Deepak Nitrite, Shilpa Medicare, ones at a 52-week low, L&T, M&M, ONGC from the large cap space, Allahabad Bank and a Bajaj Corp. Let's highlight the movers and shakers. Bandhan Bank is up in trade as the RBI has lifted the restriction on opening new branches. So good news on that front. Sanofi India on the back of strong Q3 numbers is up in trade. Cipla did fall in trade, and this is after receiving the warning letter from the US FDA for their Goa manufacturing facility. You have IRB Infra as well. They've bagged the Mumbai-Pune Expressway project, and that's what, you know, gave IRB that push. Moving away from there, you have a Yes Bank. You have CARE Ratings, which has placed its bonds on credit watch with a negative implication, and that's what has kept Yes Bank on the tender hooks. MTNL, it's an interesting one. That stock did zoom in trade, and this is despite losing subscribers in the month of December. So no major, you know, news coming on that front. Adani Transmission has declined for a third consecutive session, and a Lemon Tree Hotel, second consecutive session where there is pressure building up on that counter. Moving away from that, IOL Chemicals is also another stock to watch out for. Four consecutive sessions where the stock has rallied and it rose almost 15 to 16 times. In fact, the volumes have also been pretty strong on IOL Chemicals as we speak. Moving away from an IOL Chemicals, let's quickly see as to, you know, what the markets are looking like right now, because yes, we are off the day's low, but the volatility is expected to remain high. Last couple of tradings, we did see a lot of gyrations that did come in the markets in the last 45 minutes of trade. If that continues in today's session as well, don't be surprised if we do see, you know, a pretty neutral close in today's session. But overall, the best is to take care of your stop losses, especially in terms of where the longs are created, because overall, you are expecting a downward trend right now. There is that pressure from the global markets that's trickling in on the domestic front as well. That's all that we have in the afternoon update. Thanks for watching, and you could subscribe to our Nirmal Bank channel on YouTube and follow us on Twitter and Facebook for more updates. Thanks.